this thing, the core understanding of Chinese metaphysics. I like this because this is really the core of the foundation of every metaphysics knowledge, okay, is to understand that life itself is influenced by these three luck. We call it the heaven luck, earth luck, and man luck. For those who doesn't know Chinese metaphysics, it's okay. These are just terminology. You don't have to feel that it's heaven, earth, and man. You don't have to feel that way. Back then, no, not creative enough. They don't give nice names, okay? So basically, this cosmic trinity itself, if you translate it in normal layman terms, what it really means is you can see life itself. In life itself, there are things that you can't change and you can't control, okay? And these things that you can't change and can't control, they still affect us as human beings, right? And what are these? These are our astrology chart, our Bazi chart. We can't really choose when we are born. We can't really choose what time we are born, okay? It just happened like that. All right, maybe for some of you guys who think that it's coming or whatsoever, okay, that is another story. But still, it's something that we cannot consciously control. We cannot change. We have to live with it, whatever it is, right? And another thing that you can't control is the time. If you are living in this universal time frame, right? Time itself, we are in the same time. Every minute, every second, we are at the same time zone. Okay, you can't move back. Okay, we only living at the present. It's something that you can't control. Okay, no matter what, right? Unless you're in Star Trek, you travel, you travel back to another time zone or whatsoever. Okay, other than that, you know what? Time is something that you can't control. Okay, it's something we can't control. We only can live on. All right. So these things itself, it does affect us no matter what. Right. Another factor that is going to influence us in a lot of things is something that we can't control and we can change. And that is what I refer to as the earth luck. Things like the earth luck is and something that you can't control and can change is perhaps the environment that you are in. All right. Maybe when you are born, you are placed into this part of the world, you know, somewhere in the east or the north or whatsoever, right? You can't change what is around you because you don't, although you don't choose to be there, right? You can't change, you know, you can't control what's around you and stuff. But what you can do is you can change them. But what I mean is change if your environment is not right for you. Perhaps I could also relate this to parenting environment, your external environment. If that is not right for you, if that doesn't bring you any good, okay, and you know it, you can change it. You can't control it. It's like parenting environment is more into like childhood development stuff, how you are being brought up, okay? So these are the environments. So if you know that, okay, your environment during your childhood is not that great, it leads you to become someone you don't like, you can change yourself. You can change to be a better person. Perhaps you move away to some place. You move to a certain place which is a better feng shui or whatsoever, right? So you can change that, but you can't control. Okay, so this is really also something that at least you can do something with it, is to change it, right? That's why sometimes, right, why it's also quite good to change environment. You know, sometimes when you go to some place, you feel more inspired. And it's like, sometimes you go to some place, you feel very gloomy, you got no mood to work and things like that. So, it's very important sometimes for you to be sensitive to the environment. I'm sensitive to the environment. That's why sometimes when you go to some house, you feel like not right means not right, you know, I don't like this place. But some people, they go in, they say, oh, it's very nice, you know. So why? You know, because we relate differently with environment, we sense environment differently. But you see, what's important to know is not only it exists, but also to know that you can change them. All right. Another thing is also on something that you can control and can change. That is what I call the man luck, which is something very important, very crucial. Sometimes I know that I emphasize so much on these things, but I think it's very, very important because these are the mindset that we all have to instill at the very beginning, regardless whether or not metaphysics enthusiasts, sometimes we get, you know, too much and forget about the foundations. And also for non-metaphysics understanding, it's important to understand this, because once you know what's going to happen, and if you understand these factors, right, you know that it's a natural occurrence that there are things that you can't control. So this in fact, it's something that teaches us to be happier in life, really, to be honest. And the sorry, I got distracted. The man luck itself is referring to something that we can control, and something that I refer it also to the willpower, your action, your decision, right? So at times, right, you know you can change. You know you can do something to change, but if you do not take control of the situation and the circumstances and change it through an action, nothing will change. Only maybe your mind will change, or maybe your hair will change by falling more hair, okay, because you think too much. So really, there are things that you can control and can change. And why this triangle is very important is because cause these things, okay, it's not to say that life is fixed, okay? Astrology chart, your Bazi chart, yes, it's fixed, but you have to understand it's just one part of the segment. It's only one part. But, you know, you can still adjust yourself through your own actions and your environment. You can adjust. There are possibilities, right? This is the mindset that you have to instill to yourself no matter what. Okay, nothing is fixed in this world. That is the first thing. And nothing is not changeable. I think that's so in Yi Jing, we learned that, okay, it's the wisdom of Chinese metaphysics. So the reason why we are learning this and I'm sharing this with you is because this information is very important so that we can play around with this. Okay, I used to play around with this because it's a very nice information for us to use to live a better life moving forward. No matter what, that's why this is my personal liking of this, how I do it this way. Some things that we can't control and we can't change, I would choose to reflect on them. I cannot totally ignore them, because many times things that have happened, many times our past experiences teach us a lot of lessons. So you can't change them, you can't control them, okay? But what you can do is to reflect on them. And we have to learn from all the past experiences that we make and we, you know, deal with, you know? So we can reflect on them. We also can, as for environment, there's a chance for you to readjust them, okay? And also we have to respond to them, not react to them, okay? In short, if we are looking at this, okay, we can actually deal with this new economy if we maintain this core mindset. Yeah, no matter what, basically, I wouldn't just say about this new economy, because you know what? After this new economy, there's another new economy, and there's another new economy. That's never going to stop. But what's important is the concept of how to deal with all these things. The details, the strategy, it's later, right? That comes with also experts coming in and tell you what to do next.